Next question is from Benelux Ryder. What are your thoughts on intra-workout carbs? Are they really necessary if pre- and post-nutrition is well planned out?
I think it's funny.
Yeah, so intra-workout carbs.
You just got marketed to.
Yeah, is like drinking like a sports drink or, you know, carbohydrates while you're training. Studies show that there is a benefit for people who are working out for long periods of time.
Yeah,
like so rigorously.
Yeah, so if you're like, you know, you're doing like a 2 hour, 3 hour, 4 hour like session where you're hiking like crazy, kayaking, you know, running, or you're doing a really, really long, drawn-out session, then it makes sense to have carbohydrates because then your body can use those to replenish glycogen stores to give you more of that energy.
It's such a splitting hairs conversation.
For most people. For everybody.
Even the example you just gave, it's still splitting hairs. It really is. I mean, and here's the deal. Like, because my peers, when competing, did stuff like this. And you know what? Hey, if you are, you know, you're tracking sleep, you're measuring, you're weighing your food, you're weighing yourself, you're tracking your ounces of water every day, your sodium intake, like you are like dialed on every aspect of training and eating. Like, okay, sure, play with that. You know, you can do that. But I mean, I can tell you from my experience personally, I mean, I worked my way all the way up to a professional bodybuilder without worrying about that stuff, without worrying about the timing of my meal post-workout, without doing any sort of an intra-workout carbohydrate. Like, none of that stuff is going to make a big difference. And I'm talking on that level. Even on that level, it is still splitting hairs. For the average person, is it worth it?
It's
a waste of time.
For endurance athletes who are doing long bouts of endurance, there is benefit.
Sure, yeah. You're a marathon runner, you're an OC racer, and you're pushing, you know, two-hour long runs and with exercise or doing it multiple times a day.
Then it makes a difference.
Sure.
And studies support that. But I will say this, and here's the reason why it makes a difference, okay? When you're an athlete and you're going to go do a marathon or go do a 3 or 4 hour mountain bike ride or whatever, your body only has the capacity to store something like 6,000 to 8,000 calories worth of carbohydrates in liver and in muscle. And for high performing athletes doing these long duration,
you could burn all that.
You could burn it all out and you're gone and you hit the wall and then you're screwed. There is another option. The other option is to be keto adapted, go into these endurance sessions that require low to moderate levels of exertion for long, long periods of time.
Right.
Because even a lean athlete will have something like 30 to 40,000 calories worth of fat that they can use and convert into ketones.
Not really something to consider if you're an explosive athlete.
Not if you're explosive, but if you're like a long distance runner or you're going to go. I remember when I was.
Zach Bitter did this.
I remember when I was keto adapted, both Jessica and I were keto adapted, and I never kayak. I'm not an endurance athlete. I lift weights, but we went kayaking in Lake Tahoe. We were supposed to find this campsite, got totally lost, ended up kayaking for, I don't remember what it was, like 5 or 6 hours with no food or anything. And I for sure thought, we're going to need to pull over, something's going to happen. We were both fine. And it was because we were running off of ketones the whole time. Now, if I was not keto adapted, I'm pretty sure I would have hit a wall and totally, you know, conked out or whatever. So that's your other option. If you're lifting weights, it's a waste of time. Mm-hmm. It's not going to do you any benefit to have carbohydrates.
There's no major advantage
in the middle of your workout.